Well, good Wednesday evening to you. Welcome to our Manna in the Middle service. This is our midweek opportunity to slow down, to stop what we're doing, pause, reflect, catch a breath, and catch up with one another. So I welcome you here to the Community Life Center here at Brookings First United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Krista Ducker, and together with my colleague, Pastor Pete, we are glad that we can minister together with you this evening. I want to welcome especially our confirmation students who are visiting with us as well before their confirmation class this evening. Hey guys, glad to see you here with us tonight. Let's pray together. Gracious and holy God, we come to you rejoicing in this brief but wonderful respite from the cold weather, as it has been just glorious in this region over the past few days. We thank you, Lord, for this reminder that change comes, that there is beauty in every season, and that you are unchanging. We can depend on you at all times. As we come together this Wednesday evening, I pray that you'll remind us of the love that you have for us that moves us to love one another. It is good to be in your house, even if that is in our own houses tonight. And as we continue through Lent, we pray that we would be mindful of your journey to the cross, that as you graciously allow us to accompany you, we would learn from your example of sacrificial love and faithfulness. We thank you in all these things, and we give you the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we are continuing in our Lenten series, Surprise the World, the Five Habits of Highly Missional People. You may have had the chance to look at the video this week. If not, check it out. We're starting a new topic. So I invite you to join us as we continue on with that. There are study guides and books available for you if you would like to follow along in the book. And then we will continue this throughout Lent until Holy Week. And this week we're starting with a slightly different practice. So you may have noticed, if you've been following along the last couple of weeks, we have been looking at mostly outward practices. So those things that can help us to be distinctive among our peers, among those people around us, so that we do something just a little bit different, catches people off guard, makes them curious about what makes us different, loving, welcoming, gracious people. Of course, that is the Holy Spirit and the grace of God within us, right? But these outward gifts have been the gifts of blessing, the practice of blessing those with whom we come in contact, giving without expecting recognition or anything in response, just doing it for the good of it and because we love our neighbors. Well, that was the first week. And then last week, Pastor Pete talked to us about sharing in meals with one another. Sharing the gracious gift of food and time together with one another. What a blessing it is when we can do that, especially with those that we may not even really know very well. People who may be outside of the church or outside our faith or outside our circle. What a gift to bring in those people so that we can be blessed together by our shared companionship. So those have been the two outward habits that we have been cultivating over the past couple of weeks. Well, today we're going to take a little bit of a turn inward, and we're going to look at the habit of listening. Listening. This is actually can be kind of tough and intimidating for a lot of us. How do we do that well? And as I first looked at it, I assumed that when I read the chapter, it would be all about how do you listen to someone. The other two, habits have all been about what we do with other people. We bless, we eat together, so we listen to each other. And it surprised me to find that really the focus for this missional habit is on listening to God first. In fact, as I recall, I don't really think the author mentions listening to another person at all. It's all about how we develop a listening posture before the Lord. I thought that was interesting, and it's such a change from what we've been talking about. It made me think about how there is this balance in our faith lives between the outward and the inward. So I want to talk a little bit about this listening practice, what we find out from Scripture, and what we can learn and practice ourselves. Of course, in the Psalms, there's a lot that talks about prayer and about listening to God. But one of the most probably well-known commands that comes to us in the Psalms comes out of Psalm chapter 46, verse 10. It simply says, "Be still and know that I am God." And the Psalm goes on, "I am exalted among the nations, I'm exalted among the earth." But the important thing is, be still and know that I am God. So there is something about stilling ourselves that makes us receptive to knowledge and awareness of God in our midst. And if we need an example of someone who practiced that, of course we can look to Jesus. If you've read any of the Gospels, you will know that over and over and over throughout the Gospels, it says that Jesus went away to pray. And there's a summary statement that comes to us in Luke chapter 5, verse 15, which begins, "Yet the news about him, Jesus, spread all the more, so that crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sickness." And then it goes on, "But Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed." Jesus withdrew. He would withdraw to a mountain. He would withdraw to a lonely place. He would withdraw to a garden and spend time in communion with God. If Jesus, who is God, made that such a regular practice so that dozens of times it's mentioned in the Gospels, how much more is it a practice that we should develop as a habit in our own lives? So Jesus went away in solitude to pray, and often it happened after he had been around lots of people. Often it happened after he had given healing to people, after he had performed great miracles. You would suddenly find that almost immediately, it seems, he goes off to spend time alone in solitude praying. And it's interesting, when we think about prayer, we often think about talking, don't we? Just like if we think about having a conversation, we may think more about what we're going to say than about what we're going to hear. Isn't that interesting? I don't know if you've ever had this happen. Maybe you've been in a conversation with someone and it just kind of felt like you couldn't get a word in edgewise. And you walked away from the conversation thinking, I don't think I even had a chance to say anything about my life. Like, I just didn't get a chance to talk at all. I don't really feel heard at all because the other person is talking. Another thing that makes me feel a little bashful is when I've been in conversations with people and I leave and I think, I don't know hardly anything about that person. Did I even listen to them at all, or was I just so into what I was saying that I just didn't stop? See, listening is such an active and important part of our conversations and, in fact, of our prayers. If all we ever do is come to God with a laundry list of all the things we need as if God is some kind of divine ATM machine, we're not really listening. We're not engaging in conversation in a meaningful way. We're not expecting, perhaps even, that God would speak back to us. So what would it look like for us to cultivate the habit of listening in our relationship to God, and then perhaps even eventually with others? Well, that is a big topic. So tonight I just want to focus on three characteristics of listening, of active listening, that can help us perhaps to get into the right mindset. And then we're going to try something ourselves in a few minutes. So let's think about the practice of solitude as listening, the way Jesus practiced solitude in his prayer life with the Father. See, the thing is, when we go away to a quiet place on our own, what we find, perhaps over time, is that listening is not passive. Listening is active. Have you ever tried to really listen to someone? To really catch what they're saying and hold on to their words so you don't miss anything? Have you ever been on the edge of your seat listening to someone speak, it is not a passive exercise. Listening is very active. Perhaps you gain a posture of attentiveness. Even if you're by yourself, maybe your feet are on the floor and your hands are folded quietly and you're sitting with a posture that is receptive and open to hear. It's active. You're not sitting without paying attention. Listening pays attention to the one speaking. So it's active and not passive. The second thing about silence in solitude and during this practice of listening is that silence is not empty. Silence is not empty. Our minds are full. But as we empty our minds of all the activity, we find that there are things that we hear in the silence and the solitude as we listen for the Holy Spirit. So in a little while, we're going to go through a practice, and I'll explain it more. But as we begin to cultivate this habit of solitude before God, of active listening to what God would say to us, I encourage you to notice what you notice. Don't keep track, don't keep score, don't compare with anybody else. Just notice what comes along to you, what passes through your mind without judgment. Simply notice what you notice in the silence. Because silence is full. It's not empty. And the third thing that I want us to consider as we practice this habit of listening in silence and solitude. Listening is not doing anyone a favor. Listening is receiving a gift. It is receiving a gift. So when we come before God in our quiet, there is a temptation to say, "Hey, God, look what I'm doing for you. I'm devoting 20 minutes of my day to just sit here and do nothing. Aren't you proud of me? Aren't you happy with me, God?" You see, we're not doing God a favor. Now, God loves our listening. God rejoices when we spend time listening for the Holy Spirit. God is happy when we want to draw near to him. But we receive the gift of God's presence. See, the practice of solitude and listening is to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit at work in our hearts. Not to focus on what a holy, pious thing we're doing. So these are some things that we can think about as we begin to cultivate this week the habit of solitude, the habit of active listening to God. Remembering that listening is not passive, it's active. We create a posture of attentiveness and awareness, ready to hear what the Holy Spirit would have for us. We recognize that the silence is full, not empty, and that when we allow our minds to be receptive, the Holy Spirit fills that space. It may not happen in the first 2 minutes, or 5, or 10, or 30. But the Holy Spirit speaks to us if we quiet our hearts enough to hear. So notice what you notice in the silence. And that when we come to the Lord in our solitude, we do so open and receptive to receive the gift that God would have for us in this precious time. It is ironic that in a book about missional habits, we are not being told about how to listen to other people. If you do a Google search on how to listen, there's plenty of stuff out there. But in this book, the focus is on first listening to God for what God would have for us. And then perhaps after some time, we may be prepared to listen to another well. So let's practice that this week. Let's practice active listening in the quiet and the solitude. So I'm going to give you a couple of stages in this process. And the first stage is going to happen right now as we come to the close of our service. I spent some time this week, because it was so beautiful, at one of my favorite places in Sioux Falls. It's called Terrace Park. There's some lovely Japanese gardens that have been there for about 100 years, and I think they're just lovely, and there's usually a herd of geese, or flock, not a herd, a flock of geese who spend time there. It's one of my favorite places to be. So I went there and spent a few minutes just listening, and I recorded that for you. So what I want us to do is to spend the next 5 minutes listening. You may think that it's a quiet place, but as we come to it with all of our devices off and all of our chatter put away, alone and ready to hear, it's surprising what you notice. So here's what I would like you to do for the 5 minutes of this exercise. Put your phone away, turn everything off, watch, and notice what you notice. Now, again, don't keep score. Don't make a list. Don't write it down. Don't compare it with your neighbor. This isn't a competition. Just listen. And as it washes over you, notice what you notice. That's the first step. That's 5 minutes. Later this week, in the next 6 days, I encourage you to make it 10. And if you really want to, maybe you can make it 20 the next time. And instead of going to a place where there's lots of extra stuff going, find a quiet room or maybe your favorite spot to sit in the house where there's no distractions. Again, put your phone away. And this time, notice what you notice again. Because the silence is full. It's not empty. See, the first one that we're doing tonight is kind of a training exercise. The real stuff will happen later this week when you take 10 or 15 or 20 minutes in the quiet by yourself to notice what you notice. And if you find yourself being distracted by your thoughts, just notice them go away. And you may want to pray a centering phrase. We often do that. I do that when I get distracted by things that are running away with my thoughts. Perhaps you may consider the phrase from our scripture from the Psalms today, be still. Be still. If you find yourself wandering, be still. If a worry or an anxiety comes to you, notice it, let it go, and be still. Continue to repeat those words as you need to throughout that time. And pay attention to what you notice. Pay attention to what the Lord would speak to you. Notice how physiologically your body rests into an active posture of listening. Notice what that feels like. And then someday, when you're having a conversation with someone, try and do that and listen to them and notice what you notice. So let's enter into this listening exercise now. It will take 5 minutes. And I'll see you on the other side. Well, I hope you noticed some things as together we sat at Terrace Park for just a few minutes to see what might happen around us. And I hope that can motivate you to find a quieter place somewhere this week and do the same thing. Just notice what you notice in God's presence. As we close tonight, there's a song that always speaks to me about the importance of listening to the words of God, both in scripture and in those around me who listen to God as well. It's called Word of God Speak. So as we close, may the words of this song inspire us to worship, to open our hearts and our ears, to listen to God that we may become better listeners to others as well. So God bless you in the name of Christ, and we will see you soon.
Finding myself at a loss for words, and the funny thing is, it's okay. The last thing I need is to be heard, but to hear what you would say. Word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're in this place. Please let me stay and rest in your holiness. Word of God, speak. In the midst of you, beyond the music, beyond the noise, all that I need is to be with you, and in the quiet I hear your voice. Word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're in this place. Please let me stay and rest in your holiness. Word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're in this place. Please let me stay and rest in your holiness. God speak. Word of God speak.